start in D?
Yes.
Okay, and then it goes where? See,
do you
E.
Do you do the repeat on measure 13?
Right, and then we stay in E.
Yes, do the repeat?
That is the key change. Yeah.
Yeah, because it goes verse 2.
That is the key change to E.
Right. Mine doesn't. Verse 3 is still in key of D.
I thought
Good evening and welcome. My name is Michelle Garcia Bodie. I am the Director of Music at Our Lady of Lourdes Academy. I'd like to welcome you tonight to the Baccalaureate Mass and graduation ceremony for the class of 2021 and share with you a few announcements before we begin. Please silence your cell phones. In light of COVID-19, we ask that you wear your mask throughout the entirety of the Mass and ceremony, and to please refrain from kissing, hugging, and shaking hands with others outside your family during the offering of peace. In order to receive communion, please follow the instructions of the usher stationed in your area. Eucharistic ministers will be stationed throughout the facility to assist you in this process. Communion will be received only in hand. Please remove your mask only after you receive communion in your hand, and then return your mask to its proper position after you consume the Eucharist. If you are not Catholic or do not wish to receive communion, simply cross your arms over your chest and the Eucharistic minister will offer a blessing instead. We have a photographer. Please don't leave your seat to get pictures. We recognize that COVID-19 has caused our baccalaureate mass and graduation to look a little bit different, but we are so grateful that we are in a position for the class of 2021 to be able to join together with you to celebrate this momentous occasion. At this time, we ask you to please center yourself in prayer as we are about to begin the Mass. Thank you.
Buenas tardes y bienvenidos a la graduación de la clase del año 2021. La graduación es un evento formal. Les pedimos que se mantengan en sus asientos durante la ceremonia y apaguen los teléfonos celulares y otros electrónicos. Durante la entrega de diplomas, absténganse de silbar y gritar. Por favor, esperen a aplaudir al final cuando se reconozca la clase de 2021. Fotógrafos profesionales estarán tomando fotografías a cada alumna cuando reciba su diploma. Estas fotos serán enviadas por correo electrónico en las
oración sea inolvidable. Por favor, confiamos con su cooperación a nuestras instrucciones. Muchas gracias. La graduación de la clase de 2021 comenzará en unos breves momentos.
So what's funny is that I did the ring ceremony for them like a couple weeks back, and one of the girls, I guess, like the daughter of one of the radiologists at the hospital, is when I got there, he's like, "Man," and I was like, "So what are you doing here?" "My side gig." "That's like, this is my side gig, man."
my trumpet tuned down as written? Mm-hmm. You got it. So you got voluntary. Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. Please be seated. Good evening, administration, faculty, staff, family, friends, and my fellow graduates. Thank you for being here at the graduation ceremony of the class of 2021. Tonight, we all find ourselves at the beginning of an end. Our Lord's teachers and staff are celebrating an end to a long and challenging year and saying goodbye to the students they saw grow and change. Our parents are honoring our achievements and watching us complete our final milestone of childhood. And we, the class of 2021, are flipping to the final page of the last chapter of our Lord's journey, our baccalaureate mass and graduation. Let us all reflect on what has brought us here today before we take those meaningful final steps across the stage. Personally, I have been driven here by my passions and goals, but also by friends and family and by our Lord's community. After my first week at Lord's, I remember thinking that the days here are longer than anywhere else. And yet, as I stand here tonight, I find that while the days did go slow, the years went fast. For me, Lord's has been a place where I learned to rely on others and to ask for help, because I've found often our best ideas arrive through collaboration with one another. Our Lord's traditions, values, and shared experiences have molded the 204 individuals that walked in on the first day of school into a united and active senior class, a family. The theme we chose for this celebration is depicted on the banner being brought forward. It reads, "Better Together." This theme emphasizes everything that we have found to be true in these challenging yet memorable 4 years. Our class, more than any other in recent history, has proved that we are together even when we are apart. Through our screens, we formed lively class group chats to stay connected, and we planned our universal trip together. Our teachers and staff have proved that perseverance and caring for students does not stop inside the classroom. Our relationships have withstood the distance of digitized screens through a strength that at times may have seemed impossible to muster. By now, we know Philippians 4:13 by heart, which reads, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." God guided us through senior year to discern where and who we are meant to be, both in college and in life. No amount of nostalgia can take us back to the first day of senior year, just as no amount of excitement can bring us to the first day of college. All we can do is live in the present moment. So let us take this moment to show gratitude to everyone who has brought us here. To our parents, thank you for making the sacrifice of sending us to Lord's, for waking up every early morning for our freshman and sophomore years, for shuttling us to everything from sports events to prom. Thank you for being there when we needed you. To Team Ola, thank you for pushing us to not just be smarter people, but to be better people. Thank you for inspiring us and challenging us during difficult times. And thank you for preparing us not just for the challenges of college, but for the challenges of life. To my mom and dad, my biggest inspirations, thank you for being my driving force and my biggest supporters. If there's one thing I learned at Lourdes, it is that there is always something approaching, a test, a quiz, a graduation, or prom. That future will always be there. However, we must learn to appreciate what we have in the present moment as well, because that is all we are able to live. As Mother Teresa once said, "Be happy in the moment. That's enough. Each moment is all we need." By following her example, allow yourself to be present, and not just to listen, but participate in our Mass today. Let us open our hearts to what God is trying to tell us, so that we can achieve, succeed, and do all things together and with God. Please stand and welcome our celebrant, Father Julio Minsal Ruiz, and join us in singing our entrance song.
Thank you. of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It's a great honor to be invited to celebrate and lead in this final Mass of the class of 2021 of Our Lady of Lourdes. And so as we begin this ceremony, as we begin every Mass, let us come to mind and so better prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries by turning to the Lord and his mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most blessed fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, come to our aid, we pray, O Lord, and free us from every danger, so that we may rejoice in your peace through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from a letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. I rejoice greatly in the Lord that now at last you have revived your concern for me. You were, of course, concerned about me, but lacked an opportunity. Not that I say this because of need, for I have learned, in whatever situation I find myself, to be self-sufficient. I know, indeed, how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well-fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance, and of being in need. I have the strength for everything through him who empowers me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's a great honor for me to be preaching and leading you all in Mass, and it's a great honor to be here once again sharing this moment with some of you from the senior class of Our Lady of Lourdes. Of course, the last time I saw some of you was in a little bit of a different context. It was at the Belen prom, and there the context was a little bit different. You were very well dressed, as you are this evening. But the only difference was that back then you had a Wolverine next to you that was just mildly anxious, worried to make sure when was the right time to ask you to go on a dance, or busy wondering why do the ladies take so long in the bathroom. But we are here now once again, and it's a great honor for me to be leading you in this occasion. This evening marks a great landmark, for after it, you all part ways, leaving the place you have called home for four foundational years of your life. And yet, on this special occasion, today's gospel leaves us with a very relevant message. In today's gospel, Jesus gives his valedictory farewell speech to his disciples. He leaves them with a final lesson before ascending Mount Calvary for his final days on earth. And he tells them, remain in my love. The message could not be any more perfect for such a special occasion as this. Remain in Christ's love. You know, I wish you all could see what I see this evening from this vantage point. Few visions rival this breathtaking moment, seeing the graduating class of Lourdes Academy of 2021. And here is what I see. Young ladies with their back straight, their dress in perfect order, and whose outward appearance matches their inward achievement. Savor this moment. Savor this moment in all of its uniqueness, and hear to the words of Jesus. Abide, or remain, or hold on to this moment. And this is what I would like to propose for your meditation at this evening's Mass. Remain by the deep truth embedded within this moment. Embed it in the recesses of your heart. Soon, you will share the title of having graduated from Lourdes Academy with its prestigious, long-standing tradition in Miami. Lourdes is well known for producing leaders and competent ladies capable of great achievements. Keep in mind, however, that the apparent magnitude of your accomplishments have come about only in the face of great challenges. The athletes among you have pushed your bodies to the limit. The creative among you have poured their hearts into their craft. On the spiritual realm, you are no strangers to ups and downs. Each of you has sacrificed of your time, talent, and treasure in the service of others. And you have all faced the daunting challenges of learning the academic lessons necessary to earn your diplomas. And yet, the challenges thus far, which have been conquered, were oftentimes with the help and close guidance of teachers, coaches, IHM sisters, and family. But now, the sharpness you exude this evening will be put to an even greater test in the real world. From now on, it will be defined solely by the caliber of your own character. Dear graduates, may this evening in all of its splendor and grandeur remain in your hearts. When you leave, you will be tempted to glory in immaturity. You will have hearty appetites for diversion and distractions from all things serious and cumbersome. But I have news for everyone. I see no immaturity today. Keep who you are today in your heart. Remain in Christ's love. Once you leave Lourdes behind you, you will be tempted to question every value, to take the easy and often more fashionable road, and to superficially question these values until none are left. But I see no flimsiness today. Keep the woman you are today in your heart. Remain in Christ's love. You will be tempted to store up treasures in this world. Your work will one day seem like it is only worth it for its earning potential. Things like simple living and generosity will seem foolish, old-fashioned, and unnecessary. But I see no stinginess today. Keep the woman you are today in your heart. Abide in Christ's love. You will be tempted to believe in purely secular notions to the world's problems. And it may seem as though justice is something to be constructed solely by human hands, and earthly power is the end goal. But I see no conceit today. Keep the woman you are today in your heart. Remain in Christ's love. If we are honest with ourselves and the world we live in, we will be tempted to despair and withdraw, to hide our gifts and soften our sense of duty. But I see no paralysis today. I see achievers who have overcome and conquered setbacks with creativity and a sense of everlasting joy. Keep the woman you are today in your heart. Remain in Christ's love. These and so many other challenges are best fended off when you know who you are. Success will bring the most satisfaction when you have remained true to yourself, faithful to the one who made you and attuned to the higher calling of what you are made for. St. Ignatius of Loyola, the founder of the Jesuits, was fond of teaching others, when you are in consolation, such as we are now, in such a joyous and festive occasion, lock this moment in your hearts. Enshrine it in your being, so that when times of trial come, you will have this anchor to root you in this eternal truth. You will have this day as a deep core memory etched in your heart, so that this day, this space, and this hour might condense in its the walls and the traditions, the people and the teachings of Lourdes Academy, now inscribed in your soul. It is my sincere hope that you young ladies, that you whom I see right now as courageous, industrious, hopeful, and resilient, may remain in Christ's love. Hold fast to it. Hold fast to the education you have received, which have all been oriented toward this noble end, to show you the love of Christ Jesus. In the investments your parents have made for this education, in the loving and challenging lessons your teachers have imparted, in the demands of your coaches, and the trials you and your classmates have endured together, all of these are instances of and perfected in the love of Christ. Hold fast to this evening as a memory of the great challenges you have overcome, that it may strengthen you for the even greater challenges that you will face. And when you are in their midst, never lose sight of the God who made you, who loves you, and who now urges you onward. Remain in Christ's love. Heavenly Father, we come before you now, asking that you attend to our prayers and petitions.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Holy Catholic Church, Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, all ordained clergy and vowed religious, especially the IHM sisters, that they continue to be a guiding force in our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation and its leaders, that they work together to make wise decisions and uphold our country's ideals of justice, integrity, and respect, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of Team Ola, that they continue to shape the hearts and minds of their students, while reminding us that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the students of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy, that they may continue to live out the ideals built this year surrounding resilience, unity, and faith, we pray that they may continue to be the light of our school, cherish the community of sisters, and rise to the challenge of leadership. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our little sisters, the class of 2024, that they remember what we have taught them and carry love and hope in their hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the alumni of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy, may they continue to be a beacon of light in the world, fostering the values of faithfulness, love, sisterhood, and valiance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our parents and guardians, that they may know how much we love them and appreciate the sacrifices they have made in preparing us for this new stage of our lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the graduating class of 2021, may they take with them all the knowledge and experiences that God has taught them to continue to
Do all things through Christ and Mary's intercession, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are sick or suffering, especially the relatives of the class of 2021, that they receive strength and graces from God to help them deal with their daily sufferings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the loved ones close to the class of 2021 who have passed away, especially Roy Canizares, Edessa Duquesne, Dagoberto Hernandez, Ari Arteaga, and Lucas Alvarez, that their memory may live on forever and that they have found peace in heaven with Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear and answer our prayers according to your most holy will and through Christ our Lord. Amen. Of conciliation and praise, humbly asking that following the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may present our very selves as a holy sacrifice pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, You gave us through her author of our salvation, your Son Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, the host adores your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Informed by divine teaching, let us pray together. hearts in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
In our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a gesture of peace. Blessed are those who were called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I invite those who are virtual, please join me in the spiritual communion and prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself only to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you. Let us pray. Having nourished us with heavenly food, O Lord, grant that, according to the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may serve you in purity of life and magnify you with her in wholehearted praise. We ask this all through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
This graduation marks a momentous time in our lives. Today, we celebrate everything we have worked hard to accomplish in and outside of the classroom in our 4 years at OLA. However, we recognize that we have not achieved this feat alone. Many have helped us on our journey to reach this day. We, the class of 2021, would like to express our endless gratitude to those who have supported us at our lowest, encouraged us to work hard, be the best version of ourselves, and inspire us to dream. Our parents are prime examples of people who have been there for us every step of the way. I personally would like to thank my parents who gave me the values, roots, and wings to continue on my journey through life. I definitely know that my 203 sisters feel the same way. So we, the class of 2021, would like to extend a heartfelt thank you to our parents from the bottom of our hearts for all they've done to help us reach this day. Thank you.
Will the parents and guardians of the class of 2021 please stand? And bow your heads for a special blessing. Loving and gracious God, creation was your ultimate act of love, and allowing us to share in that act enables us to bring forth the blessing of our children. Tonight, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the parents and guardians of the class of 2021, whose gift of love has brought their daughters not only into this world, but to this day. May they continue to be strengthened by your love, so they may always be a place of faith, hope, and love for their daughters. In the spirit of Lord's Academy, we give special thanks for those mothers who have encouraged their daughters to follow in their steps and now join the ranks of alumnae of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy. May your blessing this night encourage the members of the class of 2021 to bring their daughters into the legacy of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy. We make this prayer in the name of Jesus our Lord and His Blessed Mother Mary. Amen. Parents, please be seated.
Thank you.
Good evening, Father Julio, Sister Carmen, administration, faculty, family, friends, and last but certainly not least, the class of 2021. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Aggie Gonzalez, and I am the senior class president of the class of 2021. It is my honor to share my reflections with you on the last four unforgettable years. Our experience here at Lourdes has definitely been one for the books. We entered in with Category 5 Hurricane Irma headlines all over the news, met soccer star David Beckham, witnessed a change in administration and in uniforms, and lived through a global pandemic. If you told my eighth grade self this, I think I would have run for the hills. Yet, if you ask me today if I would change a thing, I would say never. The experiences we've had these past 4 years have helped us to grow stronger and closer to realizing that we are truly better together. Our journey began 4 years ago when we all roamed the halls with our oversized uniforms, pristine new penny loafers, and Konkin Fox Square book bags. We all came in really focused on ourselves as individuals. We worried what clubs we would join, who we would sit with at lunch, what grade we'd get on the World History Final, how many pounds we had gained from buying a cookie and curly fries every single day, and so on. Our first Ola Fest showed that we had no idea what we were in store for. Father I said, "Let's hear it for the freshmen!" And we responded with a measly little, "Ooh." As all the other classes followed with their man-like roars, we all thought to ourselves, we have some work to do. As time went on, we learned to rely on each other to reach our goals. People like Isa Babino and Paola Padron, who made countless Quizlets for each and every single one of us. The girls who airdropped each other pictures of David Beckham when we couldn't bring our iPads. People like Alexa Sanchez, who made varsity soccer as a freshman, representing our whole class. And people like Nicole Calderon, who carried our class on her back for each and every single dress-up day. Sophomore year helped to continue foster the idea that we are better together as we all began to get really involved in different activities at school. Despite some minor setbacks like our Can Castles fiasco, we all came together to bring home an eighth in a row Penny War victory for D-Rod. We all showcased our school spirit by going to Dig Pink games, attending school musicals, and even some of us getting to dress up as Lola the Bobcat. Our Hall Wars game definitely improved thanks to our lead artist, Garo Lizama, and we were the first class to take boys on campus for the first ever masquerade ball. It was safe to say that by the start of our junior year, we had this whole better together idea in the bag. We all participated in each and every single Spirit Point event, even harassing family members to donate to the turkey run. During junior year, we not only realized we were better together, but we lived it out. Events like the first junior encounter brought about unlikely friendships and taught us the importance of relying on our sisters. As we packed into buses for the soccer states game and flooded the land with a sea of white, we showed the other school that we were really better together, and our state championship victory reflected that. In our ring mass, we sang, "You'll always find your way back home," highlighting the fact that we have a home here at Lourdes, which, in retrospect, was a perfect theme to carry with us as the world fell apart shortly afterwards. During quarantine, we all learned the importance of home. Yes, we are all forced to spend more time at home in our houses, but the home I'm referring to is the one that Sister Carmen held up in a sign on our first day of school that year. Quarantine taught us the universality of our sisterhood. Even though we weren't on campus, giving each other hugs and holding hands during the Lord's Our Father, we learned how to stay connected while staying apart. Although there was a lot to complain about, like not getting to wear the prom dress that I already sent pictures to Shobi of myself from the front, side, and back, there was also a lot of positives. We had time to slow down and reflect on what mattered most to us. And by the time senior year rolled around, it was evident that the friendships and memories we've created throughout these last 4 years were at the center of what mattered most. We knew we are better together. However, when we first came back to school in the hybrid format, with half-empty classes, pairs of eyes instead of smiling faces, and low motivation in the midst of college applications, we found it hard to hold on to the idea that we are better together. But then, something happened that fueled our fire. Our entire class banded together, everyone bringing in countless cans and supporting our fearless contributor, Catherine Moore, by Venmoing her to buy hundreds of cans from Aldi's. This is the first step we needed to moving back towards the idea of being better together. Shortly after, Sister Carmen allowed both cohorts to combine the last week of school before winter break, and that week was the happiest week of my entire year. I felt such joy coming into school every day and eating lunch with people I hadn't seen in months. And as we entered the new year, we were all allowed back on campus.
This completely allowed for us to truly embrace being better together. Despite a new schedule being released every week, we are also excited to be back home. I'd see girls who weren't close friends sitting and eating lunch together in the grotto. Experiences like Encounter were brought back in full force and taught us the importance of relying on our sisters through the good and the bad. We finally came decked out in purple in our what felt like a week of spirit days. Lourdes began to feel like home again instead of empty hallways. And the reason for that is that we are truly better together. I'd like to thank each and every one of the members of the class of 2021. You all, my sisters, have helped me grow in ways I would have never imagined. As Winnie the Pooh says, how lucky am I to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard. Thank you for the best 4 years and for allowing me to be your class president. Invite the class of 2021 to join me in singing Better Together, the theme song for this baccalaureate mass.
Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you all and remain with you forever. Amen.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Don't know me, I'm Gloria Ramos and I'm the assistant principal for academics, and it is with great privilege that I serve as the master of ceremonies for the commencement portion of tonight's ceremony, where we salute 204 seniors as they begin one chapter of their life and move forward to begin another. I would like to begin with a word of gratitude, thanking those who have made this baccalaureate mass and graduation possible. Mrs. Rogowski, our activities director, Mrs. Garcia Bode, our music director, Ms. Martinez and Ms. Tolgisi, our marketing and communications team, Ms. Pino, Ms. Diaz, and Ms. Del Toro, our campus ministry team, our maintenance crew, and our administration team, and of course, Father Julio for presiding over our liturgy, as well as Deacon Louis for assisting at the altar. Thank you, for without you, none of this could have been possible. I also want to congratulate the parents of the class of 2021, and thank you for entrusting your daughters to us during her high school years. We are so very proud of them. Please join me in welcoming our president and fellow Lourdes girl, Sister Carmen Teresa Fernandez, who would like to address the class of 2021 one last time.
Wow, we're here, girls.
I'm so excited.
But I'm sad, too. I'm really excited, though. My dear, dear graduates, as I prepared my remarks for your graduation, I came across a book, Living Reminder, by Henry Nouwen, who's a Catholic priest and an author. I've read lots of his books. He begins this particular book by describing the powerful impact our memory has on our attitudes and our behavior. Different people remember the same event differently. Each person's memory shapes her emotions, her attitudes, and her actions. That got me wondering about the varying ways that we would remember the last 4 years. We just heard Aggie's memories, and earlier in our liturgy, Erica shared some of hers. And as I've reflected, I realized that it's easy to get caught up in the difficulties of the last year and a half. Some people may even be tempted to erase these last 14, 15 months of the pandemic. But I don't want to do that. In true Lourdes girl fashion, because if I did erase that time, then I would miss out on some really special moments. And you know, just like you, I have FOMO too. For those, FOMO is fear of missing out, in case the adults in the room didn't know that. The girls taught me that. Anyway, I don't want to miss out on any special moments with any of my girls. So I reflected specifically about your class. When I think of your class, these are the things that I remember. I remember freshman theology class, full of questions, honest questions. And I remember going back to the campus ministry office and telling Father I and Miss Palomo, oh my gosh, these girls, they keep me on my toes. They ask me so many questions. Sometimes I don't know the answers. Father I eventually gave me a book so that I would stop asking him. But what I remember the most was how much I looked forward to our classes. I enjoyed being with you. I remembered your sophomore retreat. Having been serving in the campus ministry office at the time, I remember powerful moments during that retreat when I could see your faces as you discovered that God's love for you was unconditional. I felt God's presence in the gym that day as we watched the negative words that we often use to describe ourselves dissolve in those big bowls of water. Do you remember that? But what I love and hold on to the most is the memory of seeing your faces when, in the closing prayer, Miss Diaz challenged you to see yourself the way God sees you, as his beloved daughter. I remember junior year coming and all the kind notes of encouragement that you gave me when I was appointed the first president of our school. I remember my excitement and my little bit of nerves as I presented you with your school rings. Those of you that I taught, you might remember that I'm a little clumsy, so I was really afraid I would drop somebody's ring. And most recently, I remember the joy that just overflowed out of you when you returned to campus together. Just like the meditation song, Better Together, that you sang a few minutes ago. I can remember the energy the first time I heard you sing your senior chant and how much fun we had at your lock-in. You see, I have lots of wonderful memories of the last 4 years. And I was thinking about all of these memories, and I hadn't even found the best quote yet from the same book by Henry Nouwen. He says, he challenges us, says, among the best things we can give each other are good memories, kind words, signs of affection, joyful celebrations, gestures of sympathy. Good memories give us confidence and hope. We can hope for a bright new day because we have seen a bright day before. Thank you for enriching my life, our life at Lourdes Academy, with such good memories. Pause for a moment. Reflect on your own memories of the last 4 years. These memories are contained in your mind's eye, kind of like a four-year yearbook. Oh, and yearbook. Have you seen how beautiful our yearbook is? Our 2021 yearbook is absolutely exceptional. And the title Together We Bloom reminds me of this message. No single one of us could overcome challenges or can overcome challenges alone. We've seen that in the last year and a half. Now and always, we do need each other. We need the encouragement of our sisterhood. We need the challenge of our classmates. We need the support of our parents and families. We need the tireless efforts and dedication of our teachers. Together, each one of us, each one of you, has bloomed into a beautiful and beloved daughter of God. Congratulations, and God bless you. Please forgive me. This is my first graduation in person, and I have a line, a very important thing I have to say. By virtue of the authority delegated to me by the School Board of the Archdiocese of Miami and the Department of Education of the State of Florida, I hereby pronounce as graduates of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy, all those who have fulfilled all requirements for graduation and are entitled to receive a diploma.
We will now call each graduate to receive her diploma. A brief vitae will be read during the reciting of names, highlighting each student's high school accomplishments and future plans. Out of respect for each graduate and her family, please withhold your applause so that each senior's accomplishments can be heard. Ladies, please remember to keep your masks on as you walk across the stage. Solange Isabel Agüero will attend the Catholic University of America, where she will major in mechanical engineering. Solange is proud to have been a Lourdes singer for a four-year letterman on the school's varsity track and field team. Elizabeth Agurto will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in architecture, a Lourdes singer, and a four-year letterman on the cross-country and track and field teams. Elizabeth is proud to be the founder and leader of the Ola Casserole Ministry during her senior year. Isabella Lunel Alamo will attend Florida State University, where she will major in marketing and graphic design. Isabella is most proud to have been given the opportunity to hold her own contemporary museum exhibition as part of her art portfolio. Mia Michelle Alexander will attend Santa Fe College. A member of the Quill and Scroll Honor Society and Be the Light Club, Mia is proud to have served as captain of the varsity soccer team and to have been a member of the state championship soccer team. Daniela Christine Arana will attend Cornell University, where she will major in global and public health. A member of 5 honor societies and an AP scholar with distinction, Daniela is proud to have been a 4-year letterman on the varsity cross country and track and field teams and to have served as co-founder and treasurer of the Best Buddies Club. Isabella Margot Arrechavaleta will attend Florida State University, where she will major in elementary education. Isabella is proud to have provided 300 hours of community service to students in low-income communities. Victoria Marie Arguelles will attend Florida State University, where she will major in finance. Victoria is happy to have served as a peer minister and is proud of her accomplishments as president of the Best Business Honor Society. Christina Sofia Avila will attend Vanderbilt University, where she will major in neuroscience on a pre-med track. Christina is proud to have served as president of the National Honor Society of Sports Medicine. Isabella Cristina Babino will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in international studies. Isabella is proud to have been a member of 7 honor societies and to have served as vice president of the English Honor Society. Stephanie Lauren Baldor will attend Tallahassee Community College, where she will major in athletic training. Stephanie is most proud of her passion for service and helping others, completing mission trips to the Dominican Republic and Ecuador with Blue Missions and Mindo Futures, serving 555 service hours throughout her high school career. Amanda Rose Bardisa will attend Florida International University, where she will major in biology on the pre-med track. A 4-year letterman on the school's varsity cheerleading team, Amanda is proud to have served as peer minister and treasurer of the Student Council Executive Board. Madison Rochelle Barquette will attend the University of Notre Dame, where she will major in pre-health. A member of the varsity cheerleading and track and field teams, Madison is proud to have been a Bernadette Scholar, National Hispanic Scholar, co-president of the Rho Kappa Honor Society, and member of the Science National Honor Society's Executive Board. Lauren Elise Bell will attend the University of Notre Dame, where she will major in neuroscience. Having attained high academic standing within her class and our Silver Knight nominee in the general scholarship category, Lauren is proud to have been a Bernadette Scholar, Bobcat Ambassador, 4-year letterman on the varsity track and field team, and to have served as co-president of Mu Alpha Theta. Mia Catherine Bermudez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in exercise physiology. A member of the National Honor Society of Sports Medicine, Mia is proud to have been a 4-year letterman on the school's softball team, serving as captain, and to have been involved in several clubs. Gabriela Sofia Bertran will attend Miami-Dade College, where she will major in business administration. A member of the varsity track team, Gabriela is proud to have been an active member of the Be the Light Club for 2 years. Alyssa Nicole Blanco will attend Florida State University, where she will major in athletic training. A peer minister and member of student council, Alyssa is proud to have been a 4-year letterman and captain of the school's varsity swim team. Sabrina Lexi Bravo will attend Tallahassee Community College, where she will major in communications. Sabrina is proud to have been a member of Quill and Scroll Honor Society and to have served as co-president of OLA TV. Pamela Buelvas will attend Florida International University, where she will major in health sciences. Pamela is proud to have been a member of the CARE Club, along with many other organizations that serve the community. Ivana Alexandra Berkey will attend the University of Central Florida, where she will major in aerospace engineering. Ivana is proud to have been inducted into the English and Spanish Honor Societies. Perla Liz Burgos will attend the University of Central Florida, where she will major in health sciences on the pre-med track. Perla is proud to have completed over 650 hours of service, serving as co-founder and president of the Mindo Cares Club. Nicole Alexis Calderon will attend Harvard University, where she will major in psychology on the pre-med track. A National Merit Scholar, National Hispanic Scholar, and the valedictorian of the class of 2021, Nicole is a Bernadette Scholar and held leadership positions in the Psychology, Art, and Respect Life clubs, and is most proud to have made her older sisters laugh for the past 4 years.
Isabella Camargo will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business. Isabella is proud to have been a 4-year letterman on the school's varsity track and field team. Claudia Ana Candela will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biology. Claudia is proud of her constituency in various school clubs and her academic accomplishments, including being a Bernadette Scholar, AP Scholar, and member of 5 honor societies. Monique Mercedes Candela will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in psychology. A member of the Sports Medicine Honor Society, Nikki is proud to have completed over 400 community service hours and to have served as captain of the track and field team since her sophomore year, competing in 2 state championships throughout her high school career. Megan Marie Canizares will attend Northeastern University, where she will major in health sciences. Our Silver Knight nominee in the World Languages category, Megan is proud to have been a Bernadette Scholar and to have served as president of Science National Honor Society. Isabel Cardenal will attend Tallahassee Community College, where she will major in biological sciences. A member of the Sports Medicine Honor Society and Health Professionals Club, Isabel is proud to have been the head of the Sports Medicine Program at Lourdes and a 4-year letterman for the Belen Varsity Cheerleading Team, serving as captain her senior year. Cecilia Elena Cardenas will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in data science. Cecilia is proud to be the founder of the Words of Hope Club and the president of the Spanish Honor Society. Carolina Castañeda Mariattini will attend Florida State University. A member of the Health Professionals, Words of Hope, and Blue Reach Clubs, Caro is proud to have been a 2-year letterman on the varsity track and field team, a member of the Sports Medicine Honor Society, and to have served the community with Blue Missions. Ana Cecilia Castillo will attend Loyola University New Orleans, where she will major in biology on the pre-med track. Ana Cecilia is proud to have been a 4-year letterman on the school's varsity tennis team. Gabriela Alexandra Castillo will attend Florida State University, where she will major in athletic training. Gabriela is proud to have been a 4-year member and to have served as captain of the school's JV cross-country team. Valentina Castro will attend the University of California, Los Angeles, where she will major in biology. Valentina is proud to have been a member of 6 honor societies. Gabriela Sofia Chavez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in accounting. Gabriela is proud to have been a 4-year letterman on the varsity golf team and a member of National Rho Kappa and English Honor Societies. Sofia Patricia Sicarelli will attend Santa Fe Honors College, where she will major in biology. Sofia is proud to have served as president of the National Art Honor Society and Art Club, as well as vice president of the Health and Fitness Club. Sofia Elena Clark will attend Florida State University, where she will major in psychology. Sofia is proud to have been inducted into the National and Spanish Honor Societies and to have participated in more than 10 clubs during her 4 years at the school. Sofia Catarina Coronado will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Our Silver Knight nominee in the social science category for her charity, Crown Literacy Incorporated, Sofia is proud to have been a Bobcat Ambassador, Peer Minister, member of the Business Honor Society, and to have served as Treasurer of the Helping Hands Club. Lily Christiana Courtney will attend Tulane University, where she will major in marketing. A Bernadette Scholar, Lily is proud to have been a member of the volleyball team and 5 honor societies. Alyssa Christina Cruz will attend Florida State University, where she will major in biology on the plant science track. Alyssa's proudest accomplishments are her leadership positions as president of the STEM and Environmental Science Clubs, and to have been named MVP and captain of the track and field throwing team. Natalia Cuadros will attend the University of Central Florida, where she will major in biology. Natalia is proud to have been a member of the Music and Sports Medicine Honor Societies and to have served as treasurer of the Words of Hope and Law Clubs. Lauren Emanuel Cuellar will attend Florida State University, where she will major in psychology. Lauren is proud to have been a member of the Social Studies, Spanish, and National Honor Societies. Kayla Nicole Cuesta will attend Florida International University, where she will major in nursing. Kayla is proud to have been a 4-year letterman on the school's varsity volleyball team, serving as captain her junior and senior years. Alexandra Del Carmen Corbello will attend Trinity College, where she will major in neuroscience. Alexandra is proud to have served as captain of the first ever varsity lacrosse team, a Bobcat ambassador, and to have immersed herself in multiple school clubs. Ashley Christine de Cardenas will attend Florida State University, where she will major in digital media production. A 2-year member of the cheerleading team, Ashley was proud to have been awarded the All Florida Spring Digital Contest winner by the Florida Scholastic Press Association for her Ola TV show opener.
Ariana Victoria Del Andaburu will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in psychology. Paulina Maria Decker will attend the University of Florida on the pre-med track. Paulina is proud to have been a peer minister and member of 5 honor societies. Caterina Marie Del Cañal will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in architecture. Caterina is most proud of her participation in 3 honor societies, her extensive work with various service organizations, her rigorous curriculum, and profound academic growth. Alexandra Victoria Delgado will attend Tallahassee Community College. A member of the Sports Medicine Honor Society, Alexandra is proud to have been a member of the volleyball team her freshman year and to have served as vice president of the Helping Hands Club. Isabella Marie Delgado will attend the University of Central Florida, where she will major in health sciences. Isabella is proud to have played on both the soccer and volleyball teams. Emma Victoria Diaz will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in applied physiology and kinesiology. Our Silver Knight nominee in the athletics category, Emma is proud to have been a member of the varsity soccer state championship team and 6 honor societies. Jillian Marie Diaz will attend Florida State University, where she will major in history. A member of the varsity soccer and track and field teams, Jillian is proud to have been inducted into 4 honor societies and to have served as vice president of the senior class. Camila Marie Dominguez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biology. Camila is proud of her various high academic achievement awards and to have been a member of 6 honor societies and to have completed over 200 hours of community service. Carolina Andrea Dominguez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in engineering. Carolina is proud to have been on the executive board of the Writing Club, as well as an active member of the Business and Key Clubs during her time at Lourdes. Victoria Marie Dunoyer de Segonzac will attend Florida State University, where she will major in psychology and graphic design. Victoria is proud to have been a part of the community and served as a dedicated member of the Missionaries of Charity throughout her 4 years at OLA. Isabella Marie Igas will attend Tallahassee Community College. Isabella is proud to have been a four-year member of the varsity cheerleading team and to have served the community as a volunteer with Blue Missions. Bianca Beatriz Esteves will attend Southern Methodist University, where she will major in biological sciences on the pre-med track. Bianca is proud to have received her varsity letter for track and field and to have been a member of the Quillen Scroll National and Science Honor Societies. Cecilia Elvira Esteves will attend Florida State University, where she will major in psychology. A member of the National and Business Honor Societies, Cecilia is proud to have served as treasurer of the CARE Club. Alexandra Isabel Fernandez will attend the Honors College at Miami-Dade College, where she will major in accounting and finance. Alexandra is proud to have been a Bobcat Ambassador, Peer Minister, and member of four Honor Societies. Karina Fernandez will attend Florida International University, where she will major in political science. Karina is proud to have served as Secretary of the Law Club and to have been given back to the community as a volunteer for Amigos for Kids, completing 40 hours of service during the holiday season. Cristina Nicole Fernandez will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in neuroscience. A Bernadette Scholar, National Hispanic Scholar, AP Scholar with Distinction, three-year member of the Student Council, and our Silver Knight nominee in the science category, Christina is proud to have been a member of six honor societies and of having attained high academic standing within her class. Isabella Fernandez will attend Florida International University, where she will major in dietetics. Isabella is proud to have been a four-year member of the cross-country and track and field teams. Lauren Isabella Fernandez will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in health sciences. Lauren is proud to have been a member of four honor societies. Leonette Fernandez will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in finance. Leonette is proud to have been a member of the Quillen Scroll Honor Society and the cross country and track and field teams. Olivia Carmela Fernandez will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in human and development studies. Olivia is proud to have founded Diapers for Change, which raises money and provides resources to help families at Lotus House. Valerie Fernandez will attend Florida International University's Honors College, where she will major in biology on the pre-med track. Valerie is proud to have volunteered over 200 hours in her community and to have been a member of numerous clubs at her time at Lourdes. Sofia Victoria Ferrer will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in political science. A member of the JV volleyball team and the varsity tennis team, Sofia is proud to have been a student leader, serving as president of Be the Light Club and captain of the JV volleyball team. Victoria Maria Fraricciardi will attend La Universidad Navarra, where she will major in business. A two-year member of the JV volleyball team and our Silver Knight nominee in the business category, Victoria is proud to have been a member of the National French and Business Honor Societies, as well as the Business French and Be the Light Clubs. Today is her 18th birthday. Happy birthday, Victoria. Elise Laura Frias will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in psychology on the pre-med track. A Bernadette Scholar and National Merit Commended student, Elise is proud to be a member of six honor societies and to have founded the Mandarin Club her sophomore year, serving as the club's president for the last 3 years. Sofia Carmela Galan will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biology. Sofia is proud to have received an honorable mention in her Explore Vision competition. Daniela Maria Galceran is undecided as to where she will attend in the fall, but plans to major in nursing. Daniela is proud to have been a four-year member of our volleyball team, winning the Sportsmanship and Bobcat Awards at this year's sports banquet. Gabriela Giselle Garcia will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in biology. Gabriela is proud to have been one of the video editors for our school's student-run news broadcast, Ola TV, and to have been a member of four honor societies. Norma Barbara Garcia will attend Florida State University, where she will major in physics. Norma is proud to have been a member of the English, Sports Medicine, and National Honor Societies.
Patricia Adriana Garcia Saladrigas will attend the University of Notre Dame. A Bernadette Scholar and member of six honor societies, Patricia is proud of having attained high academic standards within her class, to have been a member of the first varsity lacrosse team, and to have served on the executive board of the Code Lab and Mandarin Clubs. Adriana Isabel Gonzalez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in marketing. A four-year member of the Lourdes Singers, Adriana is proud to have served as senior class president and a peer minister. Alexandra Nicole Gonzalez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in digital arts and sciences. A Bernadette Scholar and member of multiple honor societies, Alexandra is most proud of balancing her studies and her passions, and to have been featured in the Lourdes Literati and the 20th Annual Beaux Arts Student Artist Showcase. Carolyn Gonzalez will attend New York University, where she will major in global public health. A member of the Photography, Chem, and Creative Writing Clubs, Carolyn is proud to have been nominated for the Presidential Scholars Program, and all the beautiful memories and experiences she has from OLA will always remain in her heart. Liliana Sofia Gonzalez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in nursing. Liliana is proud to have served as peer minister. Natalia Andrea Gonzalez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in health sciences. A member of four honor societies, student council, and a four-year letterman on the varsity cheerleading team, Natalia is proud of her hard work and determination, for which she thanks her late grandmother, Sylvia San Pedro. Rebecca Gonzalez will attend George Washington University. Bianca Ann Gonzalez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biochemistry. Bianca is proud to have served as president of the SAD Club and a peer minister. Ariana Maria Grillo will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in psychology. Ariana is proud to have served her OLA community through her active participation in six honor societies and is a counselor at the OLA Summer STEM Camp. Alexa Reese Guell will attend Santa Fe College, where she will major in business. A member of the Photography and Blue Missions Clubs, Alexa is proud to have been a member of the soccer team her freshman year, to have founded an organization called Socks for the Homeless in partnership with St. Agatha's Hope for the Homeless, and to have been a member of the school's newspaper staff. Vanny Camila Guerra will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in architectural engineering. Vanny is proud to have been a four-year letterman on the varsity volleyball team and to have served as editor of the Key Club. Isabella Cristina Gordian will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in finance. A Bernadette Scholar and member of six honor societies, Isabella is proud to have served as president of the Respect Life Club and the Agape Prayer Group. Maya Daniela Guzman is undecided as to where she will attend in the fall, but plans to major in psychology. Maya is proud to have been a member of the Be the Light and Photography Clubs, the Science Honor Society, and to have served as team manager for the state finalist soccer team. Andrea Nicole Handel will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Andrea is proud to have served as co-president of Key Club and vice president of DECA.
Carla Patricia Handel will attend Florida State University, where she will major in biological sciences. A member of five honor societies, Carla is honored to have served as the school as a Bobcat ambassador and peer minister. Erica Rose Hengardner will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in mechanical engineering. A Bernadette Scholar and the salutatorian of the class of 2021, Erica is proud to have been featured in the Beaux Arts 19th Annual Student Artist Showcase and to have held leadership positions in the SUNY Next Club, English Honor Society, and Science Honor Society. Natalie Brianne Hervo will attend Florida State University, where she will major in athletic training. Natalie is proud to have been a four-year member of the varsity tennis team, serving as co-captain her senior year. Alexandra Marie Hernandez will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in communication arts. A Bernadette Scholar, Alexandra is proud to have been a member of the National Honor Society and the Bobcat Ambassadors Program since her sophomore year, serving as president her senior year. Victoria Isabella Hernandez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in business. Victoria is proud to leave behind a legacy of being one of the founders of the Diapers for Change organization. Isabella Alessandra Haran will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in public relations. Isabella is proud to have been a member of the Be the Light Club. Maura Ann Herholtz will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in criminology. A member of seven clubs and four honor societies, Maura is proud to have been a member of the cross-country and soccer teams and to have completed 450 hours of community service and to be recognized as an AP scholar with honor. Sophia Christine Hoyos will attend Florida International University, where she will major in dietetics and nutrition. Sophia is proud to have contributed to her school community as a member of various clubs that serve communities in need, especially a three-year member of the Key Club. Carolina Elena Iglesias will attend Florida International University, where she will major in finance. A member of the Business Honor Society, Carolina is proud to have been a member of multiple teams and clubs during her time at Lourdes. Alessandra Isabella Infante will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in political science. A varsity cheerleader and member of five honor societies, Alessandra is proud to have served as president of the Key Club, secretary of the National Honor Society, and anchor of our school student-run news broadcast, Ola TV. Haley Catherine Hayes Janice will attend Florida State University. Haley is proud to have been an active member of the Business Honor Society and to have served as vice president of the Words of Hope Club. Amanda Nicole Gianuliones will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in wildlife ecology and conservation. Amanda is proud to have been a member of the National Art Honor Society and had the honor of having her art displayed in the Literati on the Beaux Art Student Artist Showcase. Alexia Marie Jimenez will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in public administration. A two-year letterman on the varsity lacrosse team, Alexia is proud to have been a member of the team in its inaugural season. Isabella Marie Jimenez will attend Santa Fe Honors College, where she will major in interior design. A member of the Art, Spanish, and National Honor Societies, Isa is proud to have been a member of the Lourdes varsity cheerleading team her senior year. Kelsey Maria Jones will attend the University of Alabama on a pre-law track. Kelsey is proud to have been a member of the cheerleading team and the Art Honor Society. Carolina Eve Caracazze will attend the University of Florida. Having attained high academic standing within her class, Carolina is proud to be an Explore Vision Regional winner, National Merit Commended Student, National Hispanic Scholar, and to have been a member of the varsity lacrosse team in its inaugural season. Mia Victoria Kennedy will attend the Honors College at Miami-Dade College, where she will major in mass communications and journalism. A member of the Quill and Scroll Honor Society, Mia is proud to have been a four-year letterman on and to serve and to have served as the varsity, as captain of the varsity cheerleading team, and to have served as anchor of Ola TV since her sophomore year. Stephanie Gabriela Lara will attend Santa Fe Honors College, where she will major in biology. Stephanie is proud to have been a member of the Photography, Blue Mission, Spanish, and Operation Smiles Club.
Annie Louise Lesay will attend Florida International University, where she will major in biological sciences. Annie is proud to have been a four-year letterman on the school varsity basketball team. Natalie Marie Lavigna will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in accounting on the pre-law track. Natalie is proud to have served as president of both the Photography Club and Dance Honor Society, and to have been a four-year member of the Lourdes Dance Team. Victoria Elizabeth Lavigna will attend Florida State University, where she will major in business management. Victoria is proud to have been a member of the Bobcat Ambassadors Program, National Honor Society, and to have served as co-secretary of the Key Club. Katerina Alexandra Linares will attend the Indiana University Bloomington, where she will major in finance at the Kelly School of Business and Hutton Honors College. Katerina is proud to have been a four-year letterman for the Baylen Jesuit varsity cheerleading team, serving as both co-captain and captain. Isabella Maria Lista will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Isabella is proud to have served as editor-in-chief of the Fauve yearbook, creative director of the award-winning literary magazine, Literati, and the co-captain of the varsity swim team. Carolina Isabel Lizama will attend the Fashion Institute of Technology, where she will major in fashion design. A member of the Art and Quill and Scroll Honor Societies, Carolina is proud to have served as member of the yearbook staff and the creative director of the award-winning literary magazine, The Literati. Natalia Sofia Janso will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in political science. A member of student council and a Bobcat ambassador, Nati is proud to have been heavily involved during her time at OLA, both in and out of the classroom, especially as this year's president of Operation Smile Club, where she raised over $1,000 for the organization. Leah Fabiana Jobel will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biomedical engineering. Our Silver Knight nominee in the English and literary category, Leah is proud to have served as secretary of the Student Council Executive Board. Nicole Marie Yopis Martel Moros will attend New York University, where she will major in international business and relations. Nicole is proud to have served as a member of the Student Council and Vice President of both the Spanish and Creative Writing Clubs. Tiffany Isabella Lombard will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Tiffany is proud to have been a 3-year member of the Be the Light Club, serving as the club's vice president her senior year. Rebecca Renee Lopez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in political science. Becca is proud to have been a 4-year member of the varsity dance team. Mia Carolina Lin will attend Florida International University, where she will major in biochemistry. Mia is proud to have had the opportunity to attend 2 service trips with Blue Missions and to receive a lifetime of memories and lessons. Victoria Eugenia Manrique will attend the University of Florida. Victoria is proud to have served as president of the French Honor Society for the 2021 school year. Amanda Cristina Martinez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biology. Having attained high academic standing within her class, Amanda is proud to have been a Bernadette Scholar, Bobcat Ambassador, National Hispanic Scholar, and to have served as Vice President of the Environmental Club. Nicole Martinez will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in business and legal studies. Nicole is proud to have been a 4-year member of the Lord Singers and Thespian programs. Amanda Nicole Medina will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in history. Amanda is proud to have been inducted into the National English Honor Society. Isabella Victoria Menendez will attend the Florida State University, where she will major in psychology. Isabella is proud to have been a 3-year letterman on the varsity track and field team and a member of the photography club. Brooke Aubrey Merjane will attend the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill, where she will major in biology. Having attained high academic standing within her class and our Silver Knight Honorable Mention recipient in the mathematics category, Brooke is proud to have been a 4-year letterman and captain of the varsity basketball team, a National Hispanic Scholar, and to have served as Vice President of the Student Council Executive Board. Valentina Mestayer will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in public relations. Valentina is proud to have been a member of the varsity swim team, varsity lacrosse team, and the Spanish and Science Honor Societies. Catherine Sophia Moore will attend Florida State University, where she will major in retail management. Catherine is proud to have been a member of four honor societies. Isabella Danielle Morales will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in sports management. A peer minister and member of student council, Isabella is proud to have assisted in introducing the Best Buddies program to our school, serving as the club's vice president.
Kristen Malloy Morales will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in biology. Kristen is proud to have been a four-year letterman on and the captain of the school's varsity swim team. Cristina Isabella Morales will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in biology. Cristina is proud to have been a member of five honor societies. Sabrina Rose Morin will attend Drexel University, where she will major in design and merchandising. Sabrina feels extremely blessed to be a Lord's graduate, having served the school as a Bobcat ambassador and peer minister for the last 2 years. Mia Lynn Morrissey will attend Florida State University, where she will major in business. A four-year letterman on the varsity cheerleading team, Mia is proud to have been a member of the Math, English, and National Honor Societies. Isabella Cariana Motola will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in English. Isabella is proud to have earned over 450 service hours and to have been a member of five honor societies. Brianna Esperanza Munoz will attend Florida State University, where she will major in economics. A Bobcat ambassador, Brianna is proud to have been a member of the cross-country team, the track and field team, and three honor societies. Ariana Irene Nunez will attend the Tulane University Honors College, where she will major in political science. Ariana is proud to have been a member of the Lord Singers and the basketball team. Tiffany Marie Ohan will attend Florida State University on the pre-med track. Tiffany is honored to leave Our Lady of Lourdes Academy, not only speaking English, Spanish, and Arabic, but taking with her the fourth language, French, which she has mastered throughout her years at Lourdes. Nicole Alexis Oquendo will attend the Florida International University, where she will major in finance. A peer minister and Bobcat ambassador, Nicole is proud to have been a member of the Business Honor Society and to have served as captain of the first ever varsity lacrosse team. Paola Carolina Padron will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in business. A Bernadette Scholar and peer minister, Paola is proud of having attained high academic standing within her class and to have been a member of student council and to have served as president of the National English Honor Society. Bianca Palacio will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in public relations. A three-year member of the swim team, Bianca is proud to have been a member of the Art Honor Society, to have amassed 300 hours of service, and to have participated in the Blue Mission service trip the summer before her junior year. Mariana Murai Paniagua will attend Duke University, where she will major in economics. Having attained high academic standing within her class, Mariana is proud to have been a Bernadette Scholar and a member of six honor societies. Brianna Alexa Pavon will attend Florida International University, where she will major in hospitality. The Vice President of Quill and Scroll Honor Society, Sabrina, is proud to have served as Editor-in-Chief of the yearbook, La Flu, and to have served on the Executive Board of the Spanish and Health Professionals Clubs. Carolina Isabella Paz will attend Florida State University, where she will major in environmental sciences. Carolina is proud to have served as vice president of the Valhalla Club and to have been a member of four honor societies. Brittany Karina Pinochet will attend Miami-Dade College, where she will major in health professions. A four-year member of the track and field team, Brittany is proud to have co-founded Spectrum Soccer, an autism outreach service project that serves local communities, and to have been a member of the Be the Light and Mission, Blue Missions clubs. Caitlin Marie Perdomo will attend Florida State University. Kelsey Ann Perdomo will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business. Kelsey is proud to have been a four-year letterman on the cross-country team and a member of, Rho Kappa and National Honor Societies. Sofia Victoria Pereda will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biochemistry. A four-year letterman on the varsity cheerleading team, Sofia is proud to have served as editor-in-chief of the student newspaper, The Grotto, and to have been recognized as a regional winner of the 2019 Explorer Vision Science Competition for her project, the EpiPatch. Natalie Danielle Pereira will attend the American University of Paris, where she will major in film studies. Natalie is proud to have been to have studied broadcast journalism and French at Lourdes, which inspired her to pursue her further studies in film and journalism in Paris, France. Adriana Mercedes Perez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in clinical professions. Adriana is proud to have been the MVP and captain of the softball team. Alyssa Mia Perez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Alyssa is proud to have been a member of four honor societies, a four-year letterman on the varsity cheerleading team, and a national merit finalist.
Mia Isabella Perez will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in business analytics. Mia is proud to have spearheaded multiple donation drives for the underprivileged during her time at OLA. Sofia Cristina Perez will attend Florida State University, where she will major in finance. Sofia is proud to have been a member of the varsity soccer state championship team. Sofia Maria Plasencia will attend Miami-Dade College, where she will major in fashion marketing. A member of the varsity track and field team, Sofia was honored to have participated in Blue Missions and to have been a member of the Key, Be the Light, and Care Clubs. Michelle Maria Pombo will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Michelle is proud to have been a three-year letterman on the school's varsity cheerleading team. Ana Sofia Portillo will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in biology. Ana Sofia is proud to have danced competitively for 12 years and to have been in the Sports Medicine Honors Society. Carolina Maria Prieto will attend Santa Fe Honors College, where she will major in health sciences. Carolina is proud to have been a three-year letterman on the state championship varsity soccer team and to have been inducted into the Sports Medicine Honors Society. Emiliana Pulido will attend Santa Fe College, where she will major in political science. Emmy is proud to have been a member of the National and Rho Kappa Honor Societies and to have served as the goalie for the lacrosse team in its inaugural season. Vivian Isabel Quevedo will attend the University of Florida. Vivi is proud to have served on student council during her 4 years at OLA, most especially in her role as student body president. Lauren Ashley Quintana will attend Florida State University, where she will major in digital media production. Lauren is proud to have been a member of student council and 5 honor societies. Gabriela Quintero will attend Tallahassee Community College, where she will major in business. Gabriela is proud to have been a 2-year member of the Be the Light Club and the dance team. Stephanie Ashlyn Rod will attend the University of Miami. Stephanie is proud to have been a member of the National, Rho Kappa, and Spanish Honor Societies. Daniela Maria Recio will attend Fordham University, where she will major in psychology. Daniela is proud to have been a member of the National Honor Society. Alexa Lauren Reed will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in psychology. Alexa is proud of her academic accomplishments as a member of 5 honor societies, 9 school clubs, and an AP scholar. Carolina Isabel Rionda will attend Tallahassee Community College, where she will major in health and nutrition sciences. Carolina is proud to have been a member of the Lourdes dance team during her time at OLA, serving as co-captain her senior year. Elizabeth Frances Rios will attend Vanderbilt University, where she will major in medicine, health, and society. A National Hispanic Scholar, Elizabeth is proud to have served as president of the National Honor Society in her senior year. Sophia Rivero will attend Florida International University, where she will major in marketing. An active participant in the Best Buddies, Be the Light, and Spanish clubs, Sophia is proud to have volunteered on a Blue Mission service trip her junior year. Isabella Roche will attend Florida International University. Isabella is proud to have been a member of the Dance Honor Society and a 4-year letterman on the dance team, serving as captain this year. Anna Lucia Rodriguez will attend Miami-Dade College. Anna is proud of her involvement in the cross country and track and field teams and to have been named to the All-Dade First Team by the Miami Herald for 2 consecutive years. Carolina Michelle Rodriguez will attend the University of Central Florida Honors College, where she will major in creative writing. Carolina is proud to have served as co-president of the Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society and co-founder president of the Lean In Club. Anna Cristina Romagosa will attend Miami-Dade College, where she will major in developmental psychology. A member of the Quill and Scroll Honor Society, Anna is proud of having led her peers on Encounter as a peer minister and of having completed over 500 service hours during her time at OLA. Stephanie Paola Roman Ochoa will attend Florida State University, where she will major in biological sciences. A member of 5 honor societies, Stephanie is most proud of her involvement in several leadership positions as a Lourdes singer, peer minister, and swimmer. Mariana Therese Romero will attend Fordham University, where she will major in communications and culture. Mariana is proud to have served as editor-in-chief of the yearbook, Le Fleuve and president of the Quill and Scroll Honor Society. Angelina Marie Rose will attend Florida International University, where she will major in business. A member of the business club, Angelina is proud to have been a two-year member of student council and the track and field team. Gabriela Maria Ruiz will attend the Florida International University Honors Society, where she will major in economics. Gabriela is proud to have been a member of six honor societies and of her community service, where she taught school-aged children the Word of God. Jenna Nicole Ruiz will attend the Florida International University Honors College. Jenna is proud to have served as co-president of the Rho Kappa Honor Society and a peer minister. Anna Catalina Satcher will attend the University of Notre Dame, where she will major in political science and history. Our Silver Knight nominee in the speech category for her work with Voices for Children, Anna Catalina is proud to have been a National Hispanic Scholar and to have served as co-captain of the mock trial team. Alexandra Cristina Salazar will attend Florida International University, where she will major in biological sciences. A member of the volleyball team, Alexandra is proud to have been a member of the Be the Light, Care and Key clubs, among others. Sofia Maria San Pedro will attend Florida State University, where she will major in clinical professions. An active member of Key Club since freshman year, Sophia is proud to have served as co-captain of the cheerleading team since her sophomore year and to have participated in a Blue Mission service trip as a junior.
Alexa Marie Sanchez will attend Emory University, where she will major in business and play for the Emory women's soccer team. Alexa is honored to have been a four-year letterman on the school's two-time state championship varsity soccer team, serving as captain her senior year, and to have been named the Girls Soccer Player of the Year by the Miami Herald last night. Natalia Sofia Sanchez will attend Tulane University, where she will major in engineering or business. Natalia is proud to have been a four-year letterman on the varsity cheerleading team and a member of two honor societies. Carolina Isabel Sena will attend Santa Fe College, where she will major in psychology. Caro is proud to have been a member of the Thespians Honor Society during her senior year. Alexandra Nicole Sepulveda will attend Xavier University, where she will major in digital innovation, film, and television. A peer minister, Alexandra is proud to have been a member of the National and Thespian Honor Societies and is honored to have been elected as member of Student Council. Paola Maggie Socarras will attend Belmont Abbey College, where she will major in biology. A four-year letterman on the varsity tennis team, Paola is proud to have been a member of the National Honor Society and served several clubs on campus. Isabella Karina Solomon will attend American University, where she will major in neuroscience. Isa is proud to have been a member of various honor societies and clubs throughout her 4 years. Victoria Maria Stolarczyk will attend the University of Central Florida. Victoria is proud to have been a member of the National and Art Honor Societies. Katrina Marie Suarez will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in public relations. A Bobcat ambassador since her sophomore year, Katrina is proud to have been a member of the Business Honor Society and a four-year member of the Business Club. Mia Topasco will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in health sciences. An active participant in various service organizations such as Key Club and Best Buddies, Mia is proud to have served as the logistic coordinator for the Be the Light Club, captain of the junior varsity cheerleading team her sophomore year, and to have participated in Blue Mission service trip. Hannah Noemi Topchi will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in architecture. A member of six honor societies, Hannah is proud to have served the Lord's community as a member of student council and secretary for the Best Buddies Club.
Yeah! All right.
Kennedy Marie Todd will attend Florida State University, where she will major in criminology. Kennedy is proud to have served as president of the Chamber Ensemble and vice president of the Tri-M Honor Society. Cecilia Toro Zanetti will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business administration. Cecilia is proud to have been a member of three honor societies, National, Spanish, and Science. Angelina Marie Torres will attend the Florida International University. Angelina is proud to have been a member of the cheerleading team and the Ola family. Gabriela Rose Torres will attend Florida State University, where she will major in clinical professions. Gabriela is honored to have been a member of the sports medicine program, to have represented the school as a Bobcat ambassador, and to have been inducted into the National Spanish and Sports Medicine Honor Societies.
Amanda Toyocites will attend the Florida International University Honors College, where she will major in finance. Amanda is proud to have been a member of several honor societies, such as the Rho Kappa and National Honor Societies. Mariana Trujillo will attend Florida State University, where she will major in biology. A member of the National and Sports Medicine Honor Societies, Mariana is proud to have been a four-year member of the basketball team and three-year member of the softball team. Emma Teresa Udenberg will attend Florida State University, where she will major in food and nutrition science. Our Silver Knight nominee in the music and dance category for her work with Hope for Kasai, Emma is proud to have been a Lord singer and to have served as president of the Tri-M Honor Society. Teresa Cristina Valcarcel will attend Loyola University, New Orleans, where she will major in psychology. Teresa is proud to have been a Lord singer, peer minister, and to have served as president of the Thespian Honor Society. Sofia Lourdes Valderrama will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in marketing. Our Silver Knight nominee in the digital and interactive media category, Sophia is proud to have served as the founder and president of the Valhalla Veterans Club. Andrea Carolina Valdezueras will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in journalism. A Bobcat ambassador and member of numerous honor societies, Andrea is proud to have served as managing editor of the Grotto and president of the Creative Writing Club. Paola Isabel Valdezueras will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in mathematics. A Bernadette Scholar, Bobcat ambassador, and member of six honor societies, Paola is proud to have received the Rensselaer Medal from Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute, served as vice president of the SWEN Next Club, to have been part of the first ever math competition team, and to have completed over 600 hours of community service. Amanda Victoria Valladares will attend Florida State University, where she will major in psychology. Amanda is proud to have served as a peer minister Bobcat Ambassador, and Executive Board Member of the National Science Honor Society. Sofia Maria Vieira will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in business. Sofia is proud to have been a member of many honor societies. Carolina Alejandra Bilato will attend Florida International University, where she will major in art. A member of the JV cross country team, Carolina is proud to be a member of the Art and Triumph Honor Societies and to have helped create last year's Junior Ring Mass banner. Veronica Maria Bilato will attend the University of Miami, where she will major in architecture. A four-year member of the junior varsity cross-country team, Veronica is proud to have served as vice president of the Art Honor Society and to have participated in the creation of last year's Junior Ring Mass banner and this year's graduation banner. Mariana Villalobos will attend Southern Methodist University, where she will major in business marketing. Mariana is proud to have been a four-year member of the Business and Spanish Clubs and is honored to have participated in a Blue Mission service trip. Mia Margaret Visconti will attend Florida State University, where she will major in social work. Mia is proud to have served as president of the Best Buddies Club and to have been a member of the Ola music family. Ashley Nicole Williams will attend Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute, where she will major in aerospace and mechanical engineering. A four-time state qualifier in cross country, Ashley is proud to have been a member of the varsity cross country and track and field teams. She is especially proud of having served as captain for the past 2 years and of the team's third place finish at the state meet last year. Sofia Cristina Yafar will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in finance. Sofia is proud to have been an AP scholar and member of six honor societies. Bianca Sofia Zamora is undecided as to where she will attend this fall, but plans to major in business. A Blue Missions ambassador and member of the Business Honor Society, Bianca is proud to be a four-year letterman on the varsity track and field team. Daniela Zaragoza Farias will attend George Washington University, where she will major in political science on the pre-law track. Daniela is proud to have been recognized as a regional winner in the Explorevision Science Competition and to have served as secretary of the French Honor Society. Sofia Paola Saran will attend the University of Florida, where she will major in linguistics. The co-founder of SWEN Next Club, Sofia is proud to have been a member and served as president of the Guitar, Robotics, and Code Lab Clubs.
It is now my pleasure to welcome to the stage our final speaker this evening, the valedictorian of the class of 2021, Nicole Alexis Calderon.
Good evening, Sister Carmen, Sister Marianne, Ms. Prado, Ms. Ramos, faculty, parents, friends, and Ola, class of 2021. It has always been my dream to address my classmates at the end of our high school journey. Of course, that dream did not include exactly what I'd say. So, looking for guidance, I sat down in Ms. Myring's A2 Gov class. Immediately, my classmates had some suggestions and requests. Please do not mention the pandemic C word, which I won't, and keep it short, which I might. The peanut gallery was also willing to compensate me, so Catherine and Tiffany, you can pay me on the way out. This day has finally become real. Now, I just have to breathe. And I'd like to thank you all for being here. I speak for all of us when I say we appreciate wholeheartedly the opportunity to be together in person one last time. Before I get started, I'd like to give some incredibly important thank yous. Let's begin with the unsung Ola administration staff. Without you, nothing would be possible. Ms. Rogowski, you must be going crazy, but we appreciate it a ton. Thank you, Sister Carmen, all of our IHM sisters, Ms. Pino, and our campus ministry team. Our faith is stronger because of you. Thank you to my teachers, who have been my not-so-secret role models over the past 4 years. Thank you to Ms. Castellanos. I will never forget the moment you said, okay, let's make it happen. And we did. This fall, I will be attending the University of my dreams. And thank you to my Ola sisters for being just that, my sisters for the past 4 years and hopefully our lifetimes. And to my family, muchísimas gracias for cheering me on and helping me achieve things I believed could only be dreams. A special thanks to my godfather, who is quick to remind me that I get my smarts from him. My freshman year, I was scared of being a small fish in a big pond coming from a tiny middle school. Luckily, on the first day of summer iPad classes, I met Victoria, who then introduced me to all of her friends. They're all Lord singers, and I can't even sing in the shower, yet somehow I became a part of them. I do love to dance, though, and in sophomore year, I wanted to try out for the dance-off team. I thought I would be excluded because I didn't fit the mold, but my friends encouraged me and told me not to be afraid of failing. I quickly learned my fears were completely unwarranted, and I was welcome during every rehearsal. And that feeling is something that will stay forever in my heart. That feeling that everyone is embraced and welcomed. That is what a true sister is. And by the way, that year we won. These are just two of many examples of what I want to share tonight. My three eye-opening insights from what we call high school. Number one. We are connected in so many ways, especially by what we've overcome. Number two, we are brilliant in what makes each and every one of us unique. And three, we are able to truly make change when we let love be our guide to life. So to my first point, we are connected in so many ways, especially by what we've overcome. We are brought together not only in our shared experiences, but in those negative ones that we hope no one else shares with us. My life in the past 4 years has changed tremendously. As a family, my parents and I have dealt with challenges, and as a family, we have survived. My mom has been through more obstacles than most people could ever think of or even endure. Yet, she has always stood up for me, when literally standing takes every ounce of strength and every breath she has. She's taught me what it is to work through the struggles that life puts in your path. She has taught me that power can come from within and that our outlook has everything to do with how we survive. She will be beside me at every step of my journey and has changed who I am for the absolute better. I am sure all of us have dealt with tragedies, illnesses, and heartbreaks, and even a couple really bad test scores. But you pick yourself up and get through it, and one day you wake up and realize you survived. The past few months of school have been my favorite so far. I don't know why, but I felt a connection to you all that I could never have expected. I spend my focuses talking to girls, some of whom I've never spoken to before, about a class I don't even take. I'll keep it general when I say the kinds of stories we share are ones I'll never forget. As the summer nears, even though we will be apart, we will still be connected as we plan the next phase of our adult lives. We have grown from young women to young, powerful, and independent women with God's help. Please take 2 seconds. Yeah, do it. Look around, because you are sitting among plenty of women who will change the world. Speaking of God's help, I move on to my second point. We are brilliant in what makes each of us unique. We've changed a lot in these years, but the most important parts of us have stayed the same. We aren't stagnant. Instead, we've come into our own, bounded by our love for God and with Mary in all things. The best example I can think of this are my three best friends. We call ourselves the Bernie Amigas, not politically affiliated in the slightest. Instead, it's the name we gave ourselves when we realized we had all the same classes our freshman year. Who I am today is also shaped by the models of greatness they have been for me. So, in no particular order, Isa, whose love of life and others is so refreshing. Whether she notices or not, I can feel the room get brighter with her in it. Alex, she is my example of a quiet strength, a riptide that you might not notice at first, but can make the whole room roll on the floor laughing with a single joke. In other words, when she speaks, she is heard. And Akat, for whom I have two words, unrelenting passion. Her intensity is quite honestly contagious. If she sets her mind to it, she could rule the world one day, which had better happen, because she promised she'd let me use the White House bowling alley. There are parts of each of us that no one can take away. I wish I had the time to express all that I see in all 204 of us, but I don't. So I'm gonna leave that up to you guys. Look within yourselves at what makes you truly you, and do not underestimate it. Don't underestimate yourself, your family, or your sisterhood. Do not underestimate the people who love you. That also means, do not underestimate God, who will always be there with you, even when you can't see it. I can see him here today, though. I can't help but believe there's a reason that I met the friends I did and that we are all sitting here together. Now this is where it really gets good. How do we take what we've learned into the future? What can we carry with us? I know you all, so I don't have to ask you to go out into the world and have such fun. I don't have to tell you to be brilliant and shine. And I might not have to tell you this either, but since it's my last and most important point, I'll make myself very clear. We are able to truly make change when we let love be our guide to life. Let's live our lives according to love. That's what I've taken from my time at Lourdes, and I had no idea that's what the gospel was about. The love we found here, the strength we found here, and the power we found within ourselves here, that is what we take. So that when we learn that in life we might not always get the A, or score the goal. Thank God there are tons of you who play sports, because I'm afraid of the ball. We are grounded in a constant love that supersedes it all. A love that moves through generations. This is the way we make a difference, and in the future, our children can make a difference too. Looking back, I made a pretty grave mistake at the beginning of my speech. Graduation is not the end of it all. Don't think that this chapter of our lives is closed because we won't be walking the halls or stressing about excursion due dates or running down the halls away from Miss Prado because we forgot our IDs, we can still feel that connection. I never realized just how much that word, sisterhood, would come to mean. It means love, unconditional support, a feeling of home. A home we can always find our way back to. That home is Our Lady of Lourdes Academy. Thank you for your time, and let the party really begin.
And join Emma Teresa Udenberg, along with the members of the class of 2021, in the singing of our school's alma mater. This concludes the 2021 commencement exercises of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy. On behalf of Sister Carmen, the administration, the faculty, and staff, I would like to take this opportunity to once again thank the parents for entrusting your daughter's education to us and for supporting us through what has been a memorable year in more ways than we could have ever imagined. It has been a pleasure and a privilege to be a part of each of these young women's academic, extracurricular, and spiritual formation. To the class of 2021, congratulations. You are now a part of thousands of young women who have come before you as graduates of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy, and you are part of our 58-year legacy of excellence in Catholic education. May you go on and do great deeds with Mary in all things. Congratulations, thank you, and good night. Please remain seated during the recessional.